Not so live from the Gooch Street Studios. This is Dave's World of Fun Stuff.
You know what I hate? I hate when I start opening up viewer mail and I realize that the camera wasn't recording. So we're sort of halfway into this one. This is some stuff that my good pal Chickawaga Gene sent me. All the way from Cheektowaga, New York. You sent me a bunch of videos of our gig in Hamilton, Ontario, and this cool article where my friend Russ mentions the band that we had together. Russ from Killer Dwarfs mentions Penny Black and sent me some stickers. And that's cool. And then I got another bunch of viewer mail to stab open here, so let me get the camera set up and we'll get at it. Sorry I didn't get your unboxing on film, Gene. I'm a goof. Anyway, I'll try and do better next time. Stand by.
We'll go from smallest to biggest. Sounds like crackers.
This is from Mr. D. Ellis, all the way from Australia. The land down under. Oh, I may have fucked this up. Oh, excuse my language. Oh, we have the correspondence. Good day, Dave. I saw your Facebook post of a tiny block guitar, so I know you needed this. Big fingers and poor eyes make this quite a challenge. Hope to see more vids soon, as I think I've watched your back catalog several times. Best wishes from David. Very cool. Well, what did we get? Here it is. The Lego guitar. That's hilarious. I'll have to put that together. I'll wait till I'm drunk. Then I'll put it together. What do you think? Sound like a plan? Thanks, David. That's fantastic. Over 140 pieces. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Okay, let's move on to the next bit of mail.
Okay, so this one here, my ID has been recorded. My secret identity has been blown. Okay, let's see what we got.
This is also from Australia. This is from Pete. Pete, baby, what did you get me? Okay, you got me something I can't get open is what it is. Okay, out it comes. Oh, we have a correspondence. Hope this package finds you well. I thought you might like a few goodies from down under. After watching your videos, I always wind up having a good laugh, particularly at your gooched videos. Being a fellow luthier and can relate to this quite well. So in the honor of all things goochness, I have some stickers made for you to celebrate these moments of crappy guitar repairs. I think the title speaks for itself. I have also included some stickers of my own repair business name for you to share. Keep up the good work as always. If you can, please share my Facebook page. It's Harrison Finn, F-I-N-N Guitars on Facebook, I guess. And he also has a web page, which is harrisonfinnguitars.com. All one word. Get that in there. And obviously, Pete wants me to propagate his information, so he'll be stalked by people who like stalking people like us. Okay, let's have a look at these stickers to see what happened. Okay. And it's underneath the overlay, but it says, I've been gooched. I love it. That's fantastic. So there's a whole pile of those. And this is Pete's guitar repair outfit in Queensland.
Australia. So anybody who wants to find him down there, they can find him now.
Thank you, Pete. That's freaking cool. I love the goat stickers. Those are great. I want to peel one just so I can...
Okay, I see how they work. Cool. Thank you so much. Okay, on to the big box, Big Betty back here. Let's see what we got in there. I think I know what it is, but I'm supposed to do a bit of a review on that. Okay, this is from Chad at a company called Nordic Essentials. And this took a long time to get here. And it's here. Well, we have a box within a box, so let me get rid of this box. So what we have, this is a folding instrument stand. So it's nice and tiny. Could probably fit right in your guitar case or your gig bag or whatever. So open this up. It's very lightweight. Okay, we got some rubber, metal tubes. Let's see if I can just do this without having any instructions. So that folds down. This opens up. These guys slide along for a wider or a skinnier guitar. And that's sort of it. Seems pretty stable. Does it actually lock in place? So these are the guys here, Nordic Essentials, and it's Chad, and I believe these are available on Amazon. Okay, so those fold out of the way, right? These little guys fold out of the way. Well, one thing we got to do is try it out. Hang on. There's the blurb all about it. And there's the website all about it, and there's the other bit of blurb all about it. I missed a step. These back legs come out. That gives it stability. Okay, now let's try it out. Okay, so I've got my G&L bass in there, which maybe wasn't the greatest idea for an experiment. I don't know, guys, it seems a little tippy. Like, all I'd have to do, I wouldn't have to hit the guitar very hard or bump it, and it looks like it would hit the deck. So we got that. Let me just readjust the stand here and see if I can make it work a little better. Okay, so I missed another adjustment. See, I'm trying to figure it out without looking at the instructions. So this whole top piece lifted up too, so I think it's going to be a little more stable. Let's try it again. Okay, so there it is, with nothing in it. Hang on. That seems a lot better. That's going to work. That's hopefully not going to fall over. I think it would work well for an acoustic guitar. But this, you know, with the slim body on this guitar, it's, I don't think it's really well suited. Well, it works. I mean, the instrument's standing up. It's not falling over on its own. Okay. What did we? Thank you, Chad. Nordic. Put that in there. Nordic Essentials. Thank you so much. I'll be sure to put this to as good a use as I possibly can. Thanks again, and I'm going to stop right now, folks. Let's see if we can do a guitar repair. It's been a while. Cheers.